Residential developer House Talk kicks off this year's IPO run with its 700 million peso debut. Offer period is this week. And joining us this morning, the Madlambayan brother-sister tandem of House Talk, Maita and Terrence. Thank you so much for joining us and Happy New Year.
Hi, good morning.
Hi, good morning. Good morning, Mimi. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year and thank you for inviting us.
Thank you for joining us. It must be a very, very busy week for you because it's offer period for your debut. Everybody is excited for this, but let me start with this. Let me start with you, Terrence. We're back to COVID-19 alert level 3. How will this affect your business from the operations point of view, constructions-wise, delivery of supplies-wise, and from the market's point of view since you're listing, and this could just sap investor confidence?
I think not too much because eventually it will stabilize and real estate will always be a demand for real estate.
Mm-hmm. There will always be demand for real estate. Talk to us about the demand that you're seeing for this year at least.
Yeah, of course we're into mid housing. So anything that is within the proximity of a highly urbanized or developed area, you're good.
Mm-hmm. And you feel that despite the crisis, despite the pandemic, Filipinos will still demand this housing. Filipinos will have the budget to buy your projects.
Yes, I think. I firmly believe they will continue buying. The demand is still strong. And in spite of the pandemic, we did good.
Well, you did good in the last two years. We'll talk about that, Terrence, later. Maita, you know, this is a very interesting company, House Talk. It's a family corporation. It used to be, at least, and now you're going public. Yeah. Why don't you give us a 60-second pitch of your 17-year-old company now joining the big leagues this year as you go public. Tell us more about the journey of House Talk from being this family business to becoming a publicly listed company. This is a big step, really.
Yes, it's a big step for us. And first is, we are a medium real estate developer. Mm-hmm. And we used to be a private family-owned corporation. Mm-hmm. And 20% of our, we are only shelling out 20% of our stock as a company. And we started our roots. I think we started as a small... a small project in Pampanga.
Oh, okay.
And through the years, we were able to develop several projects in the Laguna, Antipolo, and Metro Manila.
Maita, is this something that was started by your parents or is this something that you siblings started together?
Actually, my mom and my dad, they started it. Mm-hmm. Okay, because during their time, you know, they subdivided some of their properties in Pampanga and made it to a farm lots. Mm. So there were some people who worked from the Middle East before. And now, but when my dad passed away, we moved to Manila and we pursue our real estate business.
Wow. Yeah. Okay. Thank you for that introduction, Maita. Terrence, you priced your IPO at 1 peso 50 centavos a piece. You know, we're coming from some IPOs that didn't do so well at the end of last year. And yet you priced your IPO at the top end of your range. What does this pricing and your timing tell us?
Yeah. Excuse me. As mentioned in the prospectus, the final offer price must determine through a book building process after securing SEC pre-effective approval and discussion between the company and the underwriter.
Mm-hmm. And you know, Terrence, whenever you hear companies pricing at the top end, that's really a sign of confidence. That's really a sign of bullishness. That you're confident despite the crisis outside, this is going to fly.
Yes, yes.
What makes you confident?
Okay.
Go ahead, Maita.
Yeah, you know what, Mimi? During the start of the pandemic, we were kind of worried. Okay? But you know, despite of that, we were able to sell and sold out some of our projects. Mm. And you know, there was really a demand in this market segment. which is from 1.7 to around 3 million pesos. Mm-hmm. And it's really surprising, Mimi, from our experience. Mm-hmm. And most of our projects from our previous developments, they're all sold out.
Wow. Okay. That's great to know. You're defying the trends of the other property companies. So you're raising over 700 million pesos. I understand 460 million will be for land acquisition. Which areas are you looking at? Are you looking to expand beyond the territories you're already in? I know that you focused on Laguna, Rizal as well. You're in Cavite, Antipolo, as well as Metro Manila. Are you looking at other areas?
Yeah, we're looking at, we're in the pipeline now, it's Mariveles Bataan, which is a 24-hectare property, and it will consist around 2,200 units,
okay,
combined with socialized and economic housing.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. You're focused on residential projects. Are you also planning, at least entertaining the possibility of getting into the office space? You know, leasing, the more recurring income revenue stream.
Mimi, maybe some other when there's opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, we want to concentrate more on our niche. Mm. And there's a big backlog of housing. There's a housing backlog for this segment, which is around 6.7 million
mm-hmm. houses. And you're looking to focus on that segment first before getting into
yes.
office.
Because that's where we are. We are now where we mastered our craft, right? And so we know. We know the market. We know what they like. We know their sweet spot for this market.
Mm-hmm. And Terrence, Maita, I know that you know the PSC is so proud of this company. In fact, they're saying you are the poster child of their handholding program for SMEs.
I know.
You're one of 30 SMEs that they're trying to assist into
yes.
growing substantially, into scaling.
Yes.
Could you tell us more about the experience? What was it like being in this handholding program, so to speak, of PSC? How long was the program? When did they approach you? Did you approach them? What are some of the things that they've done for you?
Okay, Mimi, we would like to thank the PSE and the SEC for opening their doors for the SMEs for this capital market. You know, this opportunity will help us grow more, okay? It will grow more. And, you know, they were very helpful with us. And it really helped us, like they asked us to attend these seminars mm-hmm. from these big companies, how they started, and that pushed us.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Terrence, at what point did you realize we're ready for this leap?
Yeah, we've been in the business for several years, and I believe that HCI is ready to take the next step in its growth.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And how long was the handholding process with the PSE?
Handholding process, maybe around three to five years.
5 years.
What? A year.
So you've been in talks with PSC for a much longer time. So this is not something that you just thought of last year.
No.
Yeah, we've been talking about, thinking about it, Mimi, since I think that was 23 years ago. But you know, it does push up. We have some hesitations. But when finally PSE asked us to attend to the talks of these big companies, that made us decide.
Mm-hmm. Final question, Terrence and Maita, are you confident that this stock, your stock, when it IPOs, will pop despite you know the COVID-19 noise that we're hearing, which could cause some panic in the markets? Are you confident that you can defy the odds?
Yes, Mimi. Because, you know, with or without COVID, housing is a need for every family.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Good point. Terrence, final word from you?
Yeah. Besides, happy new year to everyone. So let's watch for the offering of a house talk. And good luck to everyone.